Days after the gruesome attack on Lhubiriha Secondary School in Kasese District that left 42 people killed, including 37 students, residents have recounted the fateful night that left many families and the country devastated.
We saw people coming, carrying some guns, putting on full uniforms, and carrying some bags. Then when we are seeing them, they could say hello, and we also say responding, hello. Then when we are standing here, then we asked, we have not understanding these people. Then we entered our house. We slept under our beds. Then after that, like 5 minutes, we had some bullets. People crying.
As the grieving families whose children were burnt beyond recognition continue to wait on the DNA results to identify their loved ones, shocking details have emerged from leaders. Joachim Kamundu, the general secretary for Nyabugando II, noted that the LC1 council did not know about the operation of the school.
The school operations, I don't know them very well, because the director of the school has never reported in our office that has students. So we can't tell that we were knowing the students which were there, which was attacked.
Kamundu noted that the students would come and leave the school in a short period of time, and they were shocked by the news of the attack.
We didn't know how many people are there, because it had no students, but we're also surprised when we heard that some students were there.
Pasco Kaduba, a resident and a neighbor to the school, explains why he did not take his children to the same school, although it was in his community.
He was not cooperating with us, and we are not giving him some children. His children, the school children which he was having, he was bringing them from some other sub-counties, because he was not cooperating with us.
Godfrey Baluku Kabianga, the State Minister for Information Communication, Technology and National Guidance, says some students had been hired ahead of the donor's visit.
Most of the children were collected just to satisfy some purpose, because the donors were coming and the director wanted to show the donors that the school has children.
The army is currently pursuing the attackers from the Allied Democratic Forces, who also abducted 6 people during the raid before fleeing back towards the Democratic Republic of Congo. Officials and witnesses say guns and knives were used in the greasy late-night assault, and dormitories were set ablaze at Lhubiriha Secondary School in Mpondwe. The UPDF has since called for calm as they pursue the attackers. Report compiled by Gilbert Muhanguzi for the news.